With the start of a new year comes the ranking of Ultimate's best players from the previous season. Many different groups use their own method of determining who truly reigns supreme right now in Ultimate, but the PGRU by the team over at Panda Global easily has the most prestige of any ranking and is considered by most to be the quote-unquote official ranking. But this level of general acceptance also puts a much larger target on your back when players don't think they've been accurately placed by your algorithm. And the player who has easily been the most vocal about being robbed, and is generally the most vocal person about anything in the Smash community, is Leffen. So with this video, we aim to answer the question. Was Leffen actually robbed with his 51st placement on the Fall 2019 PGRU? Before we start taking a look at Leffen's results, I want to remind you about our on-demand coaching on ProGuides.com. Our new Pro Pass grants you free passes to our Play with Pros platform, along with a plethora of exclusive content, all posted daily. Make sure you don't miss our new Pro course with MKLeo himself, a new one with Esam, as well as others coming soon. With that out of the way, let's start at the most logical place for this discussion, outlining Leffen's performances throughout this PGR season. Leffen's season began with arguably his best performance of the year, placing 17th at the S-tiered Super Smash Con. Here he beat Meister in pools and won his legendary set against Salem. Unfortunately here though, he was swept both by Blazing Pasta's Peach and Tweak to be knocked out of the event. A few weeks later, Leffen placed 33rd at Shine 2019, another S-tiered event. This performance is for sure his worst out of the batch, as his only notable win was against Spring Area 51 member 8-Bitman, and his losses came against Best Ness and Leon's Bowser. He followed that up in September with another solid 17th placing at the S-tiered main stage. His only ranked win here was over Puppe, ranked 28th at the time, so it seemed good on paper. But when you look at how abysmal the Pokemon Trainer's season was and that he didn't get anywhere close to making the cut for the top 50, the glamour of the win, and thus the performance at the event as a whole, starts to fade away. Especially when you combine this with the fact that he lost to the unranked Richter main Nitro and Nico Shulk at main stage 2, the 17th at an S tier isn't as prestigious as one would think. Then, Leffen's final PGR event of the year was his 9th place appearance at Ultimate Summit 2. Leffen must have been quite grateful, at least before the rankings came out, that invitational events were being counted for this season's PGR, as he beat Tweak in the Pokemon Trainer Ditto, which was by far his best win of the year. And that's it for Leffen's resume. For the more dedicated Smash fan, you might be confused that Leffen's first place finish at DreamHack Winter 2019 isn't here on the list as well. There were some talented players in attendance, such as Mr. R. He was ranked 36th in the fall rankings and 44th more recently in the spring, who Leffen double eliminated from this tournament. Using the PGR event tiering system, DreamHack Winter would have needed 2 more players entered in brackets for the event to make it on the list. This for sure felt rough when the news initially broke out, but now that we see that this event could have been the thing that pushed Leffen over the precipice into the top 50, it stings a whole lot more. But a discussion on the potential flaws with the PGR system and using an algorithm-based ranking instead of the ballot-based one like what Melee uses is a huge discussion for another video that we here at ProGuides can throw together if you'd be interested. For now, let's shelf that and talk about Leffen's year comprehensively. The quality of the peak of his wins are undeniably good. Even without the full list out as of the writing of this video, Tweak and Meister are locks for top 10, which makes them great victories for Leffen to have on his resume. But the depth of wins is where Leffen tremendously lacks. Other than that, he's got Salem, and that's really it. Puppe and 8-Bitman both fell off super hard in the second half of 2019, which greatly diminished the value of taking these sets. The quality of his losses at these S tiers aren't the greatest either. When you have a player with low attendance like Leffen, every piece of information we have in this small dataset has to be heightened to fill in the gaps that other players with greater attendance have. Which does mean we can give him more credit for the Tweak and Meister wins, but that also means that the Blazing Pasta, Nitro, Nico, and Best Nest losses need to be hit with that multiplier as well. Nico placed 36th and Best Nest placed 43rd on the fall PGRU, so they shouldn't be seen as bad losses, but it makes sense that Leff would be below this tier of players. Nitro and Blazing Pasta, while both talented players as well, could be framed as bad losses for someone looking to make the cut for the top 50, as neither of these players were ranked in the spring or fall seasons. So just looking at Leffen's resume straight up, him not making the top 50 doesn't seem nearly as unreasonable as one might have first thought. But we're not done quite yet. Before we end off this video, I want to line Leffen's resume up against two other players to get a better feel on if he should have made the rankings. First is number 50 himself, the Japanese Yoshi main, Ron. Ron is a player whose skill level is a bit hard to gauge, seeing as he's only attended tournaments inside Japan within the last PGR season. And on top of that, he's only got 3 events in Japan to take data from, but let's take a shot anyway. At the B-tiered Sumobato SP6, Ron started his year by finishing 3rd, picking up his biggest win of the year over Shuton. His losses here were far from bad, dropping sets 0-2 to Ken and T, Japan's 3rd and 5th best on their latest ranking respectively. Ron followed that up with his worst event of the 3, a 17th placement at the B-tiered Sumobato SP8. He didn't pick up any notable wins here, and lost 2 close Game 3 sets to AK3's Krom and Tatsutsuyo's Mario. Finally, Ron finished off his year with a 7th place at Umabura SP6, which was rated as an A-tiered event. Here he beat 2 talented Japanese players, the recently ranked top 20 Link main T and the Lucario main Su, who struggled a bit in the second half of 2019. His losses at this final event came against Nesk's Mi Gunner and Proto Banham, so one good, one not so good. And that's it for Ron's year. So does Leffen deserve his spot instead? The pair are really close. Comparing them just by their wins, Leffen's got Tweak, Meister, and Salem versus Ron's Shuton, T, and Sue. With just that metric, I think the Swede edges out Ron by just a bit. And comparing them by their bad losses is hard to do because it involves attempting to compare the skill level of unranked players. But Leffen's list of Blazing Pasta, Nitro, Best Ness, and Nico across 4 events looks about the same or may even be better than Ron's of TK3, Tatsu, and Nesk across 3 events. So should Leffen be ranked higher than Ron? In my eyes and the way I perceive these two resumes, I'd say yes. But would I go as far to say that Leffen was undeservedly robbed of the spot that Ron got? No, not at all. These two have resumes that are pretty close to each other, so if someone, or in this case an algorithm, was to value something like what place a player finishes, then Ron could reasonably be above Leffen. Rankings are incredibly subjective, especially when comparing the resumes of two players with a small amount of results, because it requires the person looking at the resume to fill in more of the blanks themselves and make more assumptions. But let's not just leave it at one point of comparison for this video. Let's also look at the year of his fellow European Mr. R, and see if Leffen's resume is clearly better than his. Mr. R went to 8 PGR events over the span of last season, so we're going to try to run through these results as quickly as possible to not get too bogged down while still giving his events a fair look. 5th at the A-tiered Smash Factor 8, beating Javi while losing to MKLeo and Gluttony. 13th at S-tiered Evo, beating Nairo, Tease Link, and Elegance Luigi while losing to Proto Banham and Abadongo. 97th at S-tiered Super Smash Con, losing to Cells and Secret. 9th at A-tiered Switch Fest, beating Maymay and losing to Light and Gluttony. And then he finished off his year without taking any other notable wins while losing to 2 unranked Japanese players at SP5, MKLeo and Gluttony at UFA 2, Dion and Meru at Syndicate, and Quick and MKLeo one last time at VCA. So beyond his EVO performance, Mr. R was pretty underwhelming in Ultimate for the second half of 2019, which makes a lot of sense seeing how he dropped from 36th in the spring to 44th in the fall. Wins-wise, I think Leffen has him beat, as Tweak, Meister, and Salem certainly trumps Nairo, T, and Elegant in my opinion. Mr. R did have double the attendance of Leffen, but it's within the realm of possibility to say that Leffen's losses are not nearly as bad, with Mr. R being double eliminated by unranked players at SmashCon, SP5, and Syndicate. But again, I don't think you can really say that there is overwhelming evidence that Leffen deserved this spot instead of Mr. R. Again, I personally think Leffen's resume shows that he's a better player than Mr. R, but if you were to place a high value on attending more events and beating unranked players to make it far in bracket at these events, then I could see how you could rank Mr. R over the Swedish Pokemon trainer main. And there's one great way for both of these players to show off what rank they really deserve. Play some more Ultimate. Leffen has been flirting with the idea of not competing in Ultimate anymore and turning his full focus back to Melee, so it's uncertain if his Area 51 placement will end up being the anticlimactic ending to his Ultimate story. Hopefully for Leffen fans, the PGRU makes the Swede feel like he's got some unfinished business in this game, and he'll hang around for one more season, able to say that he was a top 50 player at some point in the game's life cycle. Between this, the Salem saga, and all the other peaks and valleys in Leffen's Ultimate career, he's easily been one of the most interesting characters characters in the community, and the game would be less fun to watch without them. So let's hope this is another chapter, not the final chapter. And I think that about does it for this video. Let us know in the comments if you personally think Leffen was unjustly snubbed from a place in the top 50. Also, let us know if there's any other players you think were ranked way too low or were unjustly robbed of a spot they deserved on this season's Panda Global Rankings. Make sure to subscribe to ProGuides and put those notifications on to make sure you don't miss out on any content on the competitive Ultimate scene in the future.